Hi and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we have a beginner's guide in OneNote for you. We are going to go over a couple of different things in OneNote. We'll go over how to organize your notes, how to edit your content, and then finally how to share whatever you have created inside of OneNote. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. But first, let's talk about different ways to use OneNote. I can either go down here to my search bar and type in OneNote, and I'm able to launch Microsoft OneNote for Windows 10. My second option is to go to office.com and go down here to OneNote and to start using the online version of Microsoft OneNote. This is the version that we are going to work with today. One of the nice things about OneNote is that you can use this app on many different platforms and sync all of your information. So I can have my notes on my PC, and then I can move them to my iPad, I can move them to my iPhone or my Droid phone, and I can also use them on a Mac. So sometimes I may be taking notes while I'm out shopping and I might only have my phone, and another time maybe I'm in class and I'm taking notes on my PC. So you just have a lot of variety of the platforms that you can use when using OneNote. So the first point I would like to talk about is how to organize OneNote. So over here, we have the main part of OneNote, which is called a notebook. So if you think back to school where you have a five-subject notebook, that's a good picture of what you have in OneNote. So I could create a notebook for everything home-related, everything school-related, everything work-related, etc. So within my notebooks, I have what's called a section. So these would be like those tabs that you would have inside of a five-subject notebook. And you can create different sections here. And then over here, I will have pages, which represent kind of the pages in the notebook. So let's create one here. I'm going to go down here and go to Add Notebook. And I'm going to say this one is Work. And then I will hit Create. So now I'm working within my Work notebook. So let's add a few sections. Let's say the first section is Videos. And I'm going to go down here again to add section. And the next section is tutoring. And the final section is curriculum. So you can see here, I'm assuming I'm involved in education in one form or another. So let's go to the videos section. So over here, I can have a page. So let's say that this page is my OneNote videos. So next, let me add another page. And let's say this is week one for my OneNote videos. And then I can go over to week one and I can right click on it and I can make this a subpage. So what happens is all of the pages under OneNote, these will be the pages that I have for each week when I'm making OneNote videos. So let's add another page. I'll call this one week two. And because I indented the first one, you can see that the second one is also indented. So then let's make a third one for week three. And then I can also add another page, and let's say we are going to do some videos on Word. And then I can right click on there and go promote subpage, and that will go back to the same level that my OneNote notes are on. So now I have my work notebook, my videos section, and my OneNote pages.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So let's go to part two of this video where we're going to talk about content on pages inside of OneNote. So let's go to week one. And let's say we would like to create a video on a beginner's guide. And here we can make an outline such as how to organize, content, editing, and sharing. Now this works a lot like Microsoft Word. If I highlight these, I can indent them, I can also number them, and I can treat this like an outline. So how to organize, we just went over notebook, sections, and pages. I also have a few other options when I am creating content on my pages. I can change my font in bold, italicize, and underline, change the color of my font, change the spacing of my font, etc. Those are most of the options that you have on the Home tab. But one here that I would like to show you is under Tags. So say I've already done how to organize, and I've already done the content editing, but I'm trying to figure out what kind of scripting I'm going to put in here for my sharing. I can go over to Tags, and I can put this to do right here. And you can see that I get a little box here telling me that this is still an outstanding task that I need to do inside of my notes. And that tag will stay with that section as I add spaces in here. You can see that that is not changing. It is staying with the sharing part of my outline. I can also use the microphone here to do speech to text. So let's go down here in a new part of my document, and I'm just going to show you a test of that. This is my speech to text. It's actually pretty good. And this is helpful for people who would rather speak and take notes quickly as opposed to writing them all down. If I go over here to insert, I have a couple options up here. I can insert pictures or files. Maybe I have some sample files that I would like to go along with this tutorial. I can also insert links from a website. So let's say under here, I wanted to put a link to my introduction to Microsoft OneNote video. I can go up here to insert link. And I can put the YouTube link, and I can also say intro video, and I can go to insert. And now I'll have the link to be able to go to that video whenever I want to inside of my notes. I can also go over here to draw, and this is really helpful if you're using a touchscreen or a tablet, because if I click this button here, I can draw with my finger on any of my notes. I can also change the color up here. And I can use my mouse, and I can just circle things that maybe I'll find important later on. Next, you have the View tab, and you can see different versions of this page that you have created. In this case, I don't have any other versions, but in case you need to go back to a previous one, you can see that. And you can also use the Immersive Reader, which is really great, especially if kids are learning to read, or if you need to listen to your notes on the road. So basically, this is the notes that I already have so far, and I can hit play to read it out loud, and this is why it is so nice for kids, because you will see that as the word is being said, the word is also being highlighted on the screen.
Beginner's Guide. How to Organize. Notebook. Sections.
So next time you're in the car and you're cramming for a quiz, you could take OneNote with you on your phone and have the Immersive Reader read your notes back to you, and hopefully those will get in your memory. I would also like to switch back to the Windows 10 version for a minute, because there's a couple more things on there that I would like to show you. So here I am in OneNote for Windows 10. Remember that video that I was just talking about? Well, in here I can go to Insert, and I can go to Online Video. And let's paste in that link one more time and say OK. I can actually embed a video when I'm using the Windows 10 version. And I don't even need to go out to the internet to click on that link and watch that video. I can just watch it from within OneNote. Also, something else I would like to show you. Say I went up to the draw menu and I wrote by hand OneNote. If I take this lasso tool over here and I circle what I just typed, I can go up here for ink to text. And my handwritten notes will be converted into text. So if you're someone who likes to handwrite your notes, but then you want to share them later on, you can use the ink to text option. And one more option inside the Windows 10 version. If I go to the insert menu, I can insert equations and math and symbols. I can actually write an equation for OneNote to solve. So let's say my equation is 2x squared plus 2x plus 3 equals 100. Now if I highlight that and I go up to math, I can select an action where I can graph my equation, and I can also select the option to solve for x. And that is really a lot faster than going through all those steps that we all learned in high school algebra.
But you might not want to tell your kids about this little tip. Otherwise, they may be doing this instead of actually learning algebra. And I don't know if you've noticed that every time I've been putting notes on the page, I get this little box. And this box is really nice because I can just click and drag and put my notes wherever I want. And I actually have infinite space going to the right and scrolling down. So I can really put these notes anywhere I want. Say I don't want my video over here, but I'd rather it be down here because I'd rather type up here. So OneNote is really like the ultimate page of notes, and you can just move things out of the way really quickly. So let's talk about sharing next. I'm back on office.com on my version of OneNote that's online. But if I go over here to the share link, I have a couple options here. I can go to share, and I can share directly with someone's email. And I can also copy a link where anyone with this link can edit my document. So OneNote works a lot like Google Docs, where you can have more than one person in the note at the same time, watching the other person take notes while you are taking your own notes on the same page. So after I type in an email, I can come over here and I can let people just view, or I can allow them to also edit my OneNote. But with the copy link down here, if I click on that, I can allow editing. I can also set an expiration date and also set a password for this as well. And I can give it to anyone with the link, or I can also designate only specific people that are allowed to see my OneNote. And all of this is stored in the cloud, so that's how you have it with you wherever you go, and that's how other people can edit it as well. It's not like most apps where you go to File, Save As. You really only have the option to share, because everything is already stored in OneNote in the cloud in different notebooks. So hopefully that's a good introduction for you for using Microsoft OneNote. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks again for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.